Hello students, how are you? Yes, we have been learning organic chemistry chapters. Today we are going to learn very important organic chapters is polymers. What are the polymers? Polymers are high molecular mass substances consisting of large number of repeating structural units. For example, if I take CH2 ethylene N number and do the polymerization, I am going to get polyethene. This is polyethene. Commonly we use polythene bags, right? So these are the polymers having repeated structural units. Then these are the only polymers which are polythene? No, there are different types of polythenes or polymers. So polymers can be classified based on their origin. Based on origin, they are of three types. The first one is natural polymers. What are the natural polymers? Yes, we have come across proteins. These are natural polymers. Then when it comes to carbohydrates, for example, cellulose. Cellulose is nothing but cotton. Yes, cotton fibers consists of cellulose. Proteins, cellulose, like that structures. Then, semi-synthetic polymers. Under this, we come across cellulose acetate. The common name of cellulose acetate is rayon, and there is another compound which is also used for this kind of polymerization, cellulose nitrate. So under this category we take the naturally occurring cellulose and do the derivatives by acetylation to get rayon. Under this, yes, even starch also is one of the polymers of carbohydrates. Some resins and very important natural polymer is rubber. Yes, rubber is a natural polymer. We are going to learn the structural elucidation of this rubber and the stereochemistry. Then synthetic polymers. What are the polymers what we are using now in daily life? All are, most of them are synthetic polymers. So based on their source or origin, polymers are of three types: natural, semi-synthetic, synthetic. For example, synthetic, I can take polyethylene. Polyester, nylon 66, there are number of polymers are known till day by synthetic method, etc. So these are the three types of polymers. Then how to synthesize these polymers? Let us see. Polymers can be classified based on their structure or synthetic method. So based on these two categories, broadly there are two types of polymers are known. The first one, which is common polymerization method, is addition polymerization. Addition or chain growth polymerization. And this is of three types usually. One is, the common one is free radical addition polymerization. Dear students, what is polymerization? Polymerization is nothing but the process of uniting monomers into polymer is known as polymerization. So free radical addition polymerization, which is a common polymerization method, synthetic method, for example, under this polyethylene. Then the second method is ionic type, which is very rarely we use ionic polymerization, under this polypropylene, for example, polypropylene. And under third category is coordination polymerization. Under this we are going to learn Ziegler-Natta catalysis. Yes students, so addition, chain growth, polymerization, then condensation polymerization, or step growth, or it is a step growth, stepwise growth polymerization. Yes student, so step growth polymerization is also a common method of polymerization. So this is how, under these categories, we are going to learn different types of polymers. Under this, for example, nylon 6,6, nylon 6, polyester, or pterylene. Common name is pterylene, polyesters, polyamides. Yes, these are the different kinds of polymers we are going to learn in detail. Let us see one by one. Free radical addition polymerization. So, free radical polymerization. Mechanism. Yes students, in any free radical reactions, what are the steps involved? Number one is initiation. Yes, you can give the answer. Initiation, propagation, and termination. So these are the three steps involved in free radical reaction. So to undergo this type of polymerization, usually alkenes or alkadienes undergo this polymerization in presence of free radical initiators. What are the free radical initiators? Yes, peroxides. Common peroxide, yes, I can use peroxides, dibenzoyl peroxide, or benzoyl peroxide we can say, tertiary butyl hydrogen peroxide, TBHP, acetyl peroxide, etc. Yes, you can use different peroxide. Any peroxide is going to be initiate this free radical polymerization reaction. And moreover, this reaction is conducted under high pressure. High pressure. High pressure is required, and in presence of light, light and high temperature. So these are the pre-requirements for the reaction to undergo this free radical polymerization reaction. Then what are the steps involved? Initiation. In first step, so what is going to happen? For example, if I take ethylene, n molecule, n moles of ethylene upon dibenzyl peroxide, if I write COOCOO phenyl dibenzyl peroxide, high pressure and H nu light, I am going to get the polymer of CH2, single bond CH2 and this. So the coordination, covalent bond containing polymers we are going to get. So this is polyethylene. From ethylene, upon polymerization, we are going to get polyethylene. Then what are the steps involved? Mechanism. So this undergoes through free radical mechanism. The first step is initiation. The benzyl peroxide, I can write C6H5COOCOC6H5, in presence of light undergoes homolysis. So how to show homolysis? Half hook, half fish hook arrow has to be used. In presence of light, it is going to give 2 moles of C6H5COO free radical. This, upon losing carbon dioxide, it is going to give benzyl free radical, C6H5 free radical, or I can write phenyl free radical or C6H5 free radical. Yes students, this free radical initiate the free radical in ethylene. So this is the free radical of benzene, 2 moles of free radicals of phenyl. In presence of this phenyl free radical, ethylene molecule CH2 double bond CH2 undergoes homolysis to give, this is the free radical phenyl CH2. So this free radical, whatever comes here, it forms bond with this free radical. This is the bond, then it is single bond is here, CH2, and this is the free radical. So this is the initiation step. Next follows propagation, chain propagation step. What happens in this? Take this phenyl ethyl radical, phenyl CH2. Now this is the free radical. When I add CH2 ethylene molecule, stepwise we are going to learn. So this undergoes homolysis and adds to the existing free radical of this benzene ethyl radical. Yes, so this goes on extending. Let me add one more also for your understanding, CH2 double bond CH2, to give here phenyl CH2, then CH2 followed by CH2 free radical. So this further, if I do number of steps, I am going to get, I can write propagation step like this, CH2 and CH2, n number of CH2s within the bracket, and then this is a free radical. Now this under at last set, third step, at that is termination step, put here itself. At termination step, let us say this is one and another molecule. So this is one CH2. This is from one polymer chain. When it adds to another same chain, another poly chain, polymer chain, CH2 and CH2, this is the two free radicals. When these two free radicals which are there in the reaction mixture come together, they are going to add like this. CC single bond is going to take place to give polymer like this, CH2 CH2, a number of ethylene molecules, CH2 CH2, and this side it is CH2 CH2, and phenyl, and here also N. So this is the polymer, which is nothing but in this case it is polyethylene. Yes students, so polymerization takes place by means of free radical addition polymerization mechanism. So what is going to happen? This free radical reaction follows three steps: initiation, propagation, termination. So if we take ethylene as the starting material, when we do the polymerization we are going to get polyethylene. This reaction involves or follows three step mechanism. The first step of this reaction is initiation of free radical. Benzyl peroxide in presence of light, it is going to give phenyl free radical. This phenyl free radical initiate the free radical in this ethylene to give phenyl ethyl radical. This under second step, propagation. So chain elongation takes place to give polymer of this free radical. When these two free radicals comes together after elongation up to certain extent, so they are going to chances of getting termination by adding these two free radicals. So this side it is phenyl, there is no chance to extend, add further to give, this is a polymer. So this polymer, yes, I can write like this. Phenyl, there will be very minute quantity when it is compared with the molecular chain of this ethylene chain. Only two phenyl rings will be there at the two ends. So there is no need to mention this phenyl in polyethylenes or polymers. So what is the terminal end? No need to mention, because the quantity or the presence of this phenyl radical is, phenyl molecule is very small with respect to this polymer chain. So this is how free radical polymerization takes place. Yes friends, if you have any questions you can ask me, or else please take the screenshot of this reaction. Yes, next. So what we have seen is one of the polymers we have come across is homopolymers. So another way of polymerization or classification is also known, that is based on the structures, structural units. For example, same, let us take CH2, what we are doing, ethylene, n moles of ethylene, we are going to prepare polyethylene. This is what we did just now, polyethylene. So the units what we are going to get in this polymer are same, are coming from the single unit. It is known as, this type of polymers are known as homopolymers. Homopolymers. Yes? So, other one is copolymer. Copolymer. Under this, for example, copolymer, if I take 1,3-butadiene, this is 1,3-butadiene, 1,2,3,4, 1,3-butadiene. And do the polymerization with styrene, phenyl, CH, double bond, CH2, or I can write like this, this is styrene, and do the polymerization. What I am going to get is, during this reaction, so the first, whatever the free radicals initiator takes place, this and these four free radicals, what we are going to get, it is going to form double bond here. This is the compound what we are going to get, CH, this is CH2, and here single bond, so free radicals, two free radicals, single bond, and this is CH, and one is already there, and now it takes place another double bond. So this is CH, then CH2, so this is going to form like this. This is double bond, is one double bond, so here two double bonds, in this product we are going to get one double bond. How? Yes students, it is very simple. When I write the chain elongation, so first it adds here, it forms free radical here, and here also two free radicals will be formed. So these two free radicals joins to give this side free radical, and this free radical adds to this CH, phenyl, CH2, and this is known as Buna-S rubber. Buna-S rubber or butadiene copolymer, butadiene styrene copolymer. Yes students, so here I can, for example, Buna-S, example is Buna-S. Polymers based on their structural units are of two types. So if someone says homopolymer and copolymer, simply don't worry. If the structural unit consists of only one type of monomer, then say it as homopolymer. If it is consists of one or two, or more than one, it may be two or three, doesn't matter, it is copolymer. So there are homomers, the homopolymers are there, as well as copolymers also are available in the market, right? And just now what we have seen, free radical polymers and condensation polymers, these two types of polymer, under these two types of polymers we are going to learn homomers and copolymers. So these are the two terminology to understand, which is homomer and polymer. Yes. For example, if I take ethylene itself, do the polymerization at high temperatures, say about 300 degrees centigrade, under high pressure. It is about 1000 to 2000 atmosphere, very high pressure. And free radical dibenzyl, free radical peroxide, dibenzyl free radical we are going to use, and we are going to get polyethylene CH2, and this is the polyethylene. So this polyethylene, in this method of preparation, what we are going to get is the polyethylene. So what is the nature of this polyethylene? This polyethylene, if I heat after preparation of some materials, if I heat, it is going to be soft. So when you take some buckets, this polyethylene bags, and just heat it, what it is going to happen? It is going to become soft, going to melt at just about 60 to 70 degrees centigrade. Yes, so it is going to be soft, and the moment I cool it, say about 10 degrees centigrade, if I cool it, it is going to become brittle, hard. Yes, so this is not useful, these conditions are not flexible, are not that useful to make all types of utensils, or what are the polymer containing utensils or materials, right? Materials, I can say. So this polyethylene prepared by this method, that is free radical addition method, is going to give this type of polyethylene, which is low density polymer, and the during the polymerization there is no control of how many chains are going to be added and what is the length of this CH2 polymer's chain length. There is no control. So that is why we are going to get low density polymer, because during the polymerization the free radicals what are going to form, there is a chance to undergo some branches. Like for example, if I write, so this is the linear polymer chain. There is a chance of having some branches also are there. So because of these branches, they are not close packed. So because of these branches, during the polymerization step, there is no control on the polymerization sequence. So there is a chance of getting some branches. So because of highly branched nature of these polymer chains, they are low density polymers. So because of low density polymers and there is no control over this chain length, so they are brittle, means there is a chance to break, and they are hard on cooling, and they are going to become soft just by heating. So this is one of the loophole of this free radical addition polymerization reactions. Then what to do? Yes, there is the modification to get high density polymerization by Ziegler-Natta catalysis. Natta catalysis. So what is going to happen? Mechanism I am going to explain. In this high density polymerization or Ziegler-Natta catalysis reaction, we are going to get the same polymer. We are going to get, for example, if I take CH2 ethylene itself and do the Ziegler-Natta polymerization, for example, the catalyst is triethyl aluminum and titanium tetrachloride, and the solvent usually hydrocarbon solvent, for example hexane hydrocarbon solvent, and the temperature in this reactions, it is just 60 to 70 degrees centigrade, are roughly, I can write 100 degrees centigrade, and the pressure is only 10 atmospheric pressure. So this reaction can be done just under low pressure and at just 10 atmospheric pressure, compared to this low density polymerization, that is free radical addition, radical addition reaction method. This Ziegler-Natta catalysis follows the mild reaction conditions, where we are going to get the polymer, the same polymer which is highly dense polymer, and it is, there is no chance of getting branches. So this polymer is going to be, so if this is the chain and there is no question of branches in this, and because there is no branches, it is going to have dense pack, close packing. So because of this close packing, these are high density will be high. And when it comes to the physical properties, compared to these are highly flexible and soft. If I take low density, yes, all polymers, I can say these are also poor electricity. That is why these polymers can be used to wrap the coatings of electric wires. Yes, these polymers can be used. But so in households, so these are usually flexible pipes we can use. And high density polymers, yes, commonly what we are using in our daily life are high density polymers. For example, buckets, dustbins, what we are going to use, dustbins or buckets. So these are all high density polymers. And water bottles, and some pipes, hot pipes, are which are commonly used to carry water, like that. So the major difference between low density polymers and high density polymers are the branching. So during the free radical addition polymerization, there is no control over the chain length and the branching, whereas this high density polymerization, which can be done using Ziegler-Natta catalysis, we are going to get high density polymers without branches. So because there are no branches, these polymers are going to be high density, and these are good quality, and these also are not poor conductors of electricity. So these can be used as insulators, like that. Yes, students. So let us see Ziegler-Natta catalysis, how it is going to add this type of linear chain, how beautifully it is going to conduct or construct this long chain without branching or without zigzag. Let us see. Ziegler-Natta catalysis. What is going to happen? So in this reaction, let us take ethylene, n moles of ethylene, and do the Ziegler-Natta catalysis. Triethyl aluminum, titanium tetrachloride at about 100 degrees centigrade and 10 atmosphere pressure. And we are going to get CH2 N molecule. This is polyethylene. So it is going to be high density polymer, that is linear high density polymer. Then what is the mechanism? It is very simple, students. So reality there is no, it is mechanistically, it is not yet proved, but most of that it is assumed or accepted mechanism. I can say accepted, there is no proof, but accepted mechanism says that. So the first step, what is going to happen? Triethyl aluminum, CH3, CH2, taken 3 times, alumina is going to reduce this titanium tetrachloride. What is the oxidation state of this titanium tetrachloride? It is plus 4, 2 plus 3 to give alumina chloride CH2 CH3. It was 3, now it is 2 ethyl groups are attached here, plus titanium plus 4 to titanium plus 3. Titanium plus 3 yes, plus the ethyl radical which is coming out as ethyl free radical. This is ethyl free radical, and this whole, it is going to get solidified, it is going to form a solid like structure which is active catalyst is. So I can write this as ligand to give active catalyst of this titanium, and this is 3 chlorines, and here ligand, and this ethyl is going to be attached to titanium like this, and there is a vacant position in octahedral structure, octahedral form, octahedral structure. So titanium tetrachloride is going to be reduced to titanium trichloride to give this octahedral structure where it is a vacant orbital. Vacant orbital is going to be formed by this active catalyst. This active catalyst is going to participate in polymerization. Now what is going to happen when we are going to add ethylene which is there in the reaction mixture? So this ethylene CH2 double bond CH2, now it is going to add like this. And ligand here, CH2 already here, CH3. Now I can write here CH2. This is the ethylene molecule. Now it is going to coordinate with this titanium, and the moment this double bond coordinates with this titanium, yes, so it is going to insert. So this is going to insert like this. So this when coordinates ethylene to this, and it is going to add, or insertion takes place between titanium and ethyl radical. Insertion takes place. Yes. So slowly now it is going to be, elongation is going to take place. Chlorine. There is no change. This is L. And now it is going to form, one time I am going to write CH2, this CH2, then CH2, and the old one which is there, yes, CH2 and CH3. Now how easily it is inserted, ethylene is inserted here, so polymer chain is going on, adding on, extending. Now when it adds to another mole of ethylene CH2, yes, so I can write here CH2 double bond CH2. So when it adds here, this adds to here, shall I write? Yes. So titanium chloride and ligand, and here what is going to happen, The newly one is CH2, then this CH2, and the end CH2, that is ethyl radical, is here. So when I do the repeating, since it is going on in the same vessel, so this addition is goes on extending in a linear fashion. There is no question of branches. There is no question of branches. So that is why it is going to give a linear high density polymers. Yes. So at the end, it very simple students, it is going to terminate just by adding this hydrogen. Yes, within the molecule, yes, it takes some free radical hydrogen and it gets terminated. And there is a chance of getting some limited number of chains. So there will be some control over the chain lengthening also. Yes, the amount, whatever the amount we are going to add this catalyst. So catalyst is going to be used in a minute quantity, and the number of, based on this, number of ethylene molecules or weight, we are going to get high density polymers. This is how Ziegler-Natta catalysis is very important. So that is why these people, this reaction was published in during 1955 and they got Nobel Prize in 1963. Nobel Prize 1963. So this is a breakthrough. And these polymers which are coming through Ziegler-Natta polymerization are very strong enough, flexible, and materialistically they are highly useful polymers are going to be prepared. And one more thing, by using Ziegler-Natta catalysis, we can prepare the rubber which is exactly identical with natural rubber. So natural rubber can be prepared by Ziegler-Natta catalysis. Under rubber preparation, I am going to explain. So this is the mechanism of Ziegler-Natta catalysis. Dear students, it is very important to understand this active catalyst. Yes, so this is going to form octahedral structure where there will be a vacant orbital. This vacant orbital coordinates with the newly incoming ethylene molecule to give, if I want, I can write another, yes. So intermediate structure, if I want, yes. So the first time I can write like this also, chlorine and ligand. And here CH2, CH3. And this is, I can write like this. Yes, CH2, and double bond, like this. But doesn't matter, it directly you can go on add like this to give insertion. Here it is going to undergo insertion step. Yes students, if you want, please take the screenshot of this. Next. Yes students, so now we learned that polyethylene is one of the polymers. Then the second one important polymers under addition polymerization is Teflon polymer. What is Teflon? Tetrafluoro CF2. Is it similar to ethylene? Yes. Here, tetrafluoroethylene. Upon polymerization, yes, free radical polymerization, but nowadays people are using Ziegler-Natta catalysis even for preparing this Teflon molecule to give CF2 10 moles. This is Teflon, and this Teflon is corrosive resistant. Very, very important students, corrosive resistant. Resistance means even strong acids, bases or oxidizing agents are not going to destroy this Teflon. And heat resistance. So So if you are an organic chemist, you are going to use Teflon tape will come to seal your reaction vessels during the reaction, during in hot reaction conditions. So corrosive resistance is heat resistant. That is why some peroxide reactions, yes, are going to be conducted using this Teflon. Teflon vessels also are available to conduct some corrosive reactions or highly oxidizing agents if you are going to use, for example, TBHP itself. So you can use this Teflon reaction vessel, right? So using these oil gaskets, we can prepare oil gaskets and non-stick surface, non-stick utensils surface, non-stick surface of surfaces of household utensils. So non-stick pan, what we are going to get is coated with Teflon. It is heat resistant, so it is not going to break. So this Teflon is highly heat resistant and corrosive resistant. That is why this Teflon is highly useful for preparing this non-stick surface coats, utensils, gaskets and oil seals. Right. Next, one more important polyacrylonitrile. So acrylonitrile, what is the structure? CH2 CHCl. Yes, so this is acrylonitrile. When I do the polymerization, we are going to get this is polyacrylonitrile. And there it is going to be as used as wool. It is very similar to wool. It is a synthetic wool. Synthetic wool. And this is common names of their Orlon. And there is another one, Acrylon. These are the fibers, names of Orlon and Acrylon fibers. So these are fibers, can be used to make fibers from polyacrylonitrile. And if I ask a question, just now we have learned CH2 This is, what is this? Polystyrene. Yes, we commonly use polystyrene. So, to make TV cabinets like that. So, packing material polystyrene, balls will get polystyrene. Yes, so this can be prepared polystyrene. Can be prepared from styrene. Yes, so all these three polymers, are they homomers or polymers? Copolymers. These three are homopolymers or homomers. Homomers. Homopolymers. Why? Because the unit of polymer is having only one type of unit, that is here tetrafluoroethane ethylene, here polyacrylonitrile unit, here styrene unit. That is why all these three are comes under homopolymers. Yes, thank you students. I hope you enjoyed this lecture. Dear students, please subscribe my channel if you are not yet subscribed, and don't forget to click on like button and bell button.